This episode of The Couch is proudly supported by Cafe Bella Vista Restaurant and Pizzeria. Azito, give it a go with Azito. Refresh Pure Water. And Reading Cinemas, experience the difference.
Skippy, Skippy. Oh, look, Skippy and the crew. It's a Big Couch, 503 episode to be exact, or 503 episodes. We've got a big one. Check out who's on the show today. On the show today, we've got Marnie with all her pets, and we're looking at a tawny frog mouth and some joeys. Later on, we look at WASTV and what they do with Neesha. And we also look at all the latest movies with our very own reporter, Tayla Divitini. And Marnie, what are you going to do on the show today?
How they come into care,
I look after them,
and find out about tawny frog mouths.
Can't wait, that's coming up very soon. But also, I'm going to ask you a word right at the start of the show. Do you know what the word ziziva means? Ziziva. Look it up on Google. Maybe you can find out, as well as me, when Neesha talks Scrabble very, very soon. It's a Big Couch. Let's start it now.
It's showtime on the couch. Yeah, it's showtime.
Acts are a wonderful thing here on The Couch. To open today, we've got a young girl called Lauren Marshall, and she's singing a beautiful song called Speak Now on The Couch.
I'm not the kind of girl who should be rudely barging in on a wife at occasion, but you're not the kind of boy who should be marrying the wrong girl. Sneak in and see your friends and her snotty little family, all dressed in pastel, and she is yelling at a bridesmaid somewhere back inside a room, wearing a gown shaped like a pastry. This is surely not where you thought it would be, but I lose myself in a daydream. Gestures are exchanged, and the organ starts to play a song that sounds like a death march, and I am hiding in the curtains. Seems that I was uninvited by your lovely bride-to-be. She floats down the aisle like a pageant queen, but I know you wish it was. Should be rudely barging in on a wife at occasion.
is a young girl called Lauren Marsh. I think I said her name wrong before, but it's Lauren Marsh, and she's performing at the end of the show. Thank you very much, Lauren. Now, someone that never performs on this show because she would never try to with the animals because they always upstage her. It's our very favourite ranger. I call her Ranger Marnie. She's back with another Wild Things. Over to you.
Thanks, Fred. Hi, everyone, and welcome to Wild Things. Well, Australia is the most isolated continent on the planet. It is also one of the most unique biologically because of our amazing plants and animals, and some of them are sitting right here on my lap right now today. Chittering Wild Life Carers is a non-profit organisation dedicated to looking after these animals when they're sick, injured or immature. They're 80 kilometres north of Perth in Western Australia, and Dean and Anne join us today to tell us a little bit more about these amazing creatures. Welcome to the show.
Oh, thank you, Marnie.
Now, Anne, tell us about these beautiful little guys we've got sitting on our laps today.
Well, we've got three very young Western Greys here. They're two females and a male. We've got Jelly Bean sitting on your lap, and she's they've all just had their bottles, so they're a bit sleepy. And this little one here is Ebony, and we've got Sandy.
And how did Jelly Bean come into care?
Well, Jelly Bean's mother was caught in a fence, actually, yes, and she had a badly broken leg.
Right.
And unfortunately, we couldn't do anything to help her.
Okay.
But she had in her pouch this little pinky Joey.
Oh, my gosh.
And she was really small, about 300 grams.
300 grams.
Eyes closed.
Oh. Yeah. And pinky means they don't have fur, hence the pink colouring.
Yeah.
Little cough. And now we know what they're like when they cough.
Most important thing at that stage is keeping them warm.
Right.
Temperature has to be good.
Hence the little blankets and everything.
Yeah. But more so when they're pinkies, you need to be in a little box that's got a temperature control in it.
Okay. So, yeah. Oh, they're just beautiful. Oh, they're very cute. Now, Dean, you've got a very special animal here today. Can you tell us what this bird is?
This is called a tawny frogmouth.
Right.
People often confuse it with an owl, more closely related to the kookaburra. This one's about 12 weeks old, a young bird that was handed in by a member of the public.
Okay.
There are three subspecies in Australia of tawny frogmouths. They're very similar to the owl in the look, but basically they have an apex to their head. They have an eye on either side of their head as opposed to the front like the owls.
Okay.
And they have much smaller legs and talons as such. So.
And he's making a little chirping noise at the moment, which I believe he did all the way here in
he
your car.
He did all
as
the
well.
Way here, all 80 kilometres. Kept me.
Wow.
We had a good conversation, absolutely.
Now, yeah, he's a little one. So how do they usually come in? Is it?
This one's come out of the nest for some reason, whether it was another bird of prey that knocked it out or just fell out.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Fabulous. He's quite impressive, isn't he? He's amazing.
He's stunning.
Now, obviously, these animals don't just pop into our lives for no good reason. As you've mentioned, sometimes they're falling out of the nest or mum caught in a fence. What should people do, Anne, if they do find wildlife that's injured or orphaned?
Well, the main thing is your personal safety. So if you find a kangaroo on the side of the road, then you can stop, but make sure you're safe first, because that's nothing both. But when you find a joey in the pouch of a mother who might have been hit by a car, number one, it needs quiet, it needs a dark space, and don't worry about feeding it.
Okay.
And call a local wildfire helpline.
Okay, because obviously, you know, we drive past, you see animals on the side of the road. Sometimes, especially with a large kangaroo, I guess, you know, you think, oh, they're dead, it doesn't matter, but joeys can survive, can't they?
Oh, they do. If they're small enough, they will stay in the mother's pouch until someone takes them out. Ideally, if you've got a jumper on, whip it off and wrap it around in the jumper and then call for help.
Fabulous. Thank you for those great tips. Now, Dean, if people would like to help, what can they do?
The first thing that they should do is obviously contact their local Wildlife Carers Association.
Yep. You nearly got food on.
Third time's a charm.
Hilarious. He's just punctuating that with importance.
Very much so, yep.
Okay, so definitely contact someone in your local area.
Yep, and they'll put you in contact with them, with your local wildlife carer. So.
Very important, because just like you guys, they know what they're doing.
And they do need special care.
Thank you so much for coming on. And obviously, people can also become members of your organisation. They can donate, because it's very expensive to look after our animals, particularly with the milk, isn't it?
Special milk for macropods. So, yes, that's very important.
Okay, fabulous. Well, thank you so much for coming on.
Thank you.
And good luck with these little babies. We hope they go well.
Thank you very much for the time.
Thanks everyone for joining us today. If you'd like to find out more about Chittering Wildlife Carers Inc. or how you can help them through donations or becoming a member, please go to our website at www.thecouch.com.au. That's all for now. Until next time, keep it wild.
Thanks, Marnie. And you wanted me to hold this up as well. Isn't it a cute picture?
I do.
Saying, please help me. I don't know if we can get a little bit of a close-up there. Marnie's gone to all the trouble of getting this beautiful picture. Lovely. Well done, Marnie. Thank you very much. And those animals are amazing as well.
Yeah.
And it's great what the work that the people are doing to save them as well. Thank you very much. Now, later on, we've got an author coming in talking about mental health and well-being. Her name is Tasha Broomhall. She's coming up in the next segment. She's got some books. Now, I want to just get in early because I know we always run out of time. This is the book. We've got three to give away thanks to Tash. If you would like to win one of these books, you must watch the interview coming up next. There is the SMS number on the screen there. There, if I get it right, 0439 929 929, 0439 929 929. And you can win one of those. We need your name, your address, and your phone number. And in the next segment, when we have the interview with Tash, we'll give those away and we'll get you to SMS us. I mean, you can SMS us now as well. Name and address and phone number and send it to our normal 0439 929 929. Same number for everything. Okay, as I was saying, Neesha last week came in to do a couple of great interviews. Today she's back. And she's got a great interview with the people from WASTV. Here's Neesha, over to you. Thank you.
Thanks, Fred. We're joined on the couch by Hannah and Mike from WASTV.
Hey,
welcome.
Neesha.
Hello.
How are you both today?
Yeah, I'm doing
pretty good. Yeah.
Very good. Now, WASTV has been on the couch before, but for all our viewers that may have not seen you before, what does WASTV do?
So WASTV, or WA Student TV, is a non-profit run by students who do do promotional videos for other non-profits. We also do training for students as well, so we can teach them in skills for basic camera skills or editing skills as well.
In short, we film stuff.
Wonderful. And you do it for other non-profits, and there's something about giving back to people who give back, which is exceptional.
Yeah. I feel that they deserve their chance to have their causes promoted, and it helps them out in the end. It helps us out, and I think we're all just, you know, coming together with this way. Whole cause of volunteering. It's
That's wonderful. And you recently had an event, the Lights Camera Volunteer event. Tell us about that.
That was great. Well, the Lights Camera Volunteer event was to promote the cause of volunteering to like the high school age youth of Western Australia. And it was also a great networking opportunity for the non-profit groups that we also have around here with WA. So we had the photo comp, which was for the non-profit groups to enter, and we had like 28 organisations submit photographs.
Wow.
And we also, and the high school film competition, that one turned out wonderful. A bunch of young high school age students, they all submitted these amazing little films, and it just really showed off just how important that was to them. And hopefully it sends a message out to the other young kids as well, that they too can make a difference.
And it sounds very involved. What was it like being a part of organising such an event?
Oh, it was great. We generally would work in subcommittees, so we would have some people on the photo competition, some people on the film contest, and obviously we had a committee working on our own Lights, Camera, Volunteer video, and we just basically share the load, so we just help out wherever we can.
Yeah. Gosh, that sounds very exciting. How did you think it went this year? It sounds very dynamic.
I think it went great.
Yeah.
You know, we just had a massive turnout at the actual screening. You know, we had some amazing films win the first three prizes there. You know, we had a lot of non-profit groups. They learnt who we were. They learnt who they were through one another, seeing their photos, reading about their causes. And we helped spread a lot of awareness that way through... Yeah, what we did.
We got some great feedback from the audience, so that was really rewarding.
Yeah, they loved it. They loved our video as well.
I can certainly see your passion when you both talk about it. How did both of you get involved?
Oh, so I basically auditioned about nearly 2 years ago for one of their web series, and from then, because I had a film background, it just escalated from there, basically, and I've done directing, editing, producing, and because I went to the Screen Academy last year, that's where I met Mike. Mike got involved that way, didn't you?
Yep. Hannah was like, hey, WASTV's holding quiz night. I came down. I thought, these guys are pretty cool. I might give them a shot. Asked her to let me in on that, and yeah.
Pumping. So it all went from there.
Yeah.
Yep.
God, that's exciting. So what would you say to all the young, aspiring volunteers? How would they get involved with WASTV?
So basically they can get on our website at www.wastv.org.au and they can just contact us through there or get onto our Facebook page, send us a message, tell us what you're...
That's all right, you're passionate. Yeah, what you're interested about.
Yeah, exactly.
Absolutely.
Tell us what you're interested about. And yeah, we'll see where we can help out and where you can help us out too.
And of course you need the numbers because you want to grow. What are your sort of plans with WASTV?
Well, I think we hope to expand. We hope to get more people involved. And that way we can reach out to more non-profit organisations and help spread their message across the country. And yeah, maybe someday we might expand to other states. SAS TV, TAS TV.
Ooh, he's got the names. I think he's
got the names. Over to USA, SAS TV, World TV, Galaxy
West
TV.
I think that one's doing okay on its own. Maybe. No. I've got shakes. Anyway, so, look, guys, it's great to have you on the couch, as always. I'm sure we'll have you on more. There's non-profit groups can obviously contact you as well as volunteers. So thank you. What we'll do is we'll make sure all of your information is on thecouch.com.au. As usual, we'll see you soon. Yes?
Yes.
Got the commitment?
Yes.
Thank you.
Back to you, Fred.
Neesha, always the cheeky one. I really don't like that outfit. Would you be able to change it for a different, please? Go on, you're doing a Scrabble segment next. Beautiful. She's gonna get changed, folks. I know how much you didn't like it. It was terrible. Just didn't work with the set. We'll see you after break, talking Scrabble, and don't forget that word, Zizava. Do you know what it means? Neesha finds out next.
This episode of The Couch is proudly supported by Cafe Bella Vista Restaurant and Pizzeria. Azito, give it a go with Azito. Refresh Pure Water. And Reading Cinemas, experience the difference.
Welcome back to The Couch on Aurora Television around Australia. The next segment, which I feel that I'm just too dumb to do, I gave it to Neesha. I'm really glad Neesha's going to do this next segment on Scrabble. It's about the World Championships. They're coming here up in, here in Perth. I'm looking forward to this segment. And Neesha, thank you for getting changed. You look beautiful.
Thank you, Fred. We're joined by some young West Aussie Scrabble champs today. And it's very exciting because Rahul, Marvi, Radheya and JJ from UWA and Scrabble Western Australia are here. Welcome to The Couch, guys.
Thanks.
We've all just been really excited and talking about the upcoming 2015 World Championships, which are being held right here in Perth, Western Australia. So tell me a little bit about your experience with Scrabble, Rahul, representing the country at the World Championships in the past. What's that been like?
Oh, yeah. When I found out, it was really exciting because this is the biggest thing I've done, representing Australia. Also gave me the opportunity to travel, to Sri Lanka, which was very nice.
Yeah, that would have been an amazing experience. And how old are you?
I'm 13.
13 and travelling already at World Championships. Congratulations, and Marvi as well. So how do you find representing Australia at such a young age?
I felt very privileged, and there can be a better opportunity to meet others from different cultures, and it was a very memorable experience.
That's great. And Radheya, 2015 is going to be a very exciting year for you. What are you looking forward to most?
Well, I think representing Australia on such a large scale is going to be really exciting, and it's going to be a really great experience, and I can't wait for it. Yeah.
That's really good. And JJ joining us as well. 2015 in Western Australia, what's the benefits for Perth?
Well, it'll be the first time that Perth is hosting a World Championships of any sort for Scrabble. We will have the eyes of the world on Western Australia. We'll have 150 kids from all over the world here. We'll have the senior world champion as well come down to Perth at the time, I'm pretty sure. And it's really great that these kids will be able to play for their country. Marvi has been to four countries across the world. Mm-hmm. Rahul's been to Sri Lanka. Radheya is going to be in Perth next year, but he'll look forward to representing Australia outside as well.
That's fantastic. And Western Australia has a larger number of stops. Sorry, we're playing in the studio here as well. I can see Fred back there trying to work out some words that we've got on the thing. We'll come back to that. But Perth will have more people being able to represent, won't they, than usual?
Yes. In the past, we've only had three or four people representing Australia for the World Youth Championships. Mm-hmm. But because it is a home tournament, mm-hmm. we have been given 20 places for the World Youth Championship. So It is, you know, any kid who's watching right now, mm-hmm. There's a very real chance that they will be able to represent their country if they start playing.
Yeah, oh, fantastic. So there's some good impetus to get started. Now, you guys play against adults as well, don't you? So Rahul, sometimes you're sitting across from someone who could be three times your age. What's that like?
Oh, it's like basically playing like a normal person, like person your age. It doesn't really matter. Like, you have small talk, you play games, and it's really fun.
That's good, because you're learning to interact with adults as well, aren't you? And,
yeah.
And the words are quite big sometimes, so it must be surprising that they get them. And Marvi, the same. You would be working with adults, or playing with adults, should I say, rather. Yeah? How do you find that experience?
Yeah, it's a challenge to play with adults, but it's a good experience because you're learning a lot of things that you don't, you've never encountered before. And, it's good fun.
So, Radheya, we're going to jump straight to the board in front of you. There's a word on there that I've been rehearsing for the last 3 hours called Ziziva. What does that mean?
Oh, I think it's a type of weevil. I'm not sure about the details, but yeah, I know it's a type of weevil, yeah.
That's interesting. So you could say I have a Ziziva in my flower. Well, that's me trying to be funny, so let's just move right along. So there's other words on there, obviously. JJ, is there one on there that, you know, you think the audience might be interested in?
Yeah, I mean, like, there's a six-letter word with all vowels. That's E-U-O-U-A-E. And it means it's a Gregorian cadence, a Gregorian music. Some of the words that they like to play include E-U-O-I, and they know the meaning of that as well.
Gosh, and what is the meaning of that one?
Oh, it's a cry of Bacchic frenzy, which basically means a cry of drunken frenzy.
Oh, gosh, well, I think that word would be useful. So how do I pronounce that one again?
I'm not sure how to pronounce it.
That's probably how people talk. Whoa! About you. That's where it came from, you know. Watch out, Wayne's World. I didn't make that up. Okay, so moving right along, let's get into the, you know, how do people get involved? Because I think there's probably a lot of kids and parents watching. So, you know, as a child and you're interested, how would you get involved in this?
Well, me and my brother got involved through my dad. Like, he was really good at Scrabble, and he taught us how to play.
That's very
and
useful.
We usually play games with my mum, my brother and my dad.
Oh, that's really nice. That's really good. But what if you're not as lucky to have, you know, a Scrabble player in your family? How can you get involved? Can you go on Facebook anywhere?
On social media websites like Facebook and things like that, there's apps and games that you can play Scrabble on. In communities and just play against random people, and there's also an app in the App Store for Scrabble too.
Okay, great. So a very easy, inexpensive way to get involved. And
if you Google Scrabble WA, you'll come to the Scrabble Western Australia page, and there are competitions every month. We organise workshops for kids who are interested in playing. Okay. So if you jump on Google and search for Scrabble WA, you'll quite easily find us. And I'd encourage anyone to adults and kids to come along to the competitions and to the friendly games with the many clubs around Western Australia.
That's wonderful. And look, it's been great having all your smiling faces on the couch. I'm sure you're going to do extremely well next year. And people, if you've missed any of that, of course, you can always go to thecouch.com.au. But thank you very much to our guests, guys. I'm sure we'll have you on again. Have a great week. Lucky, you know, good training. You don't need any luck. We'll see you soon. And I'm just a little bit flustered. I don't understand any of the words. So back to you, Fred.
Thank you, Neesha. And I love to see Neesha embarrassed. But you know one thing? She had a nicer outfit on. And we're coming back to Neesha very, very soon as well, because she's going to be talking to Frank Prokop. Can't wait for that one as well. Now, how would you like to win a $50 voucher to Fasta Pasta? My good friends at Fasta Pasta, I was there just a few days ago. It was awesome. All you have to do to win is do this. Put on an SMS, the word Fasta Pasta. That's the code word. And send it to 0439 929 929. That's the number that's on screen. Thank you, Tony. And, of course, the word Fasta Pasta with your name and your address. We're giving away $50 vouchers every week thanks to our good friends at Fasta Pasta, to all their restaurants. If you'd like to win, enter now. 0439 929 929. The word Fasta Pasta, your name and address. Anywhere in Australia, you can enter this and we'd love you to win. Thank you very much to Fasta Pasta for their great work and great support. Now it's time to go back to Neesha because she's got Frank with her. Over to you, Neesha.
Thank you, Fred, and welcome to the couch, Frank Prokop, health advocate. This is your numerous occasions on the couch.
Thank you, Neesha. It's so good to be here.
Now, Frank, we've got a very important topic to talk about today, and that's men's health.
Well, it's very disturbing that men are so bad at looking after their own health, that prostate cancer kills more people than breast cancer, that so many men will wait until the symptoms are so bad that it actually affects their capacity to survive things. Mm. I'm sorry, guys, but there is nothing right with having blood in your bowels for 3 years and then saying, I'll get around to it. The research shows also that men that have partners have much better prognosis. And that's because while it's okay to go when someone tells you to go to see a doctor, they won't go themselves. And what we want to do is change the whole mental capacity that men have to deal with their own health. So I'm proposing that we move away from the macho mentality, that I'll get through anything and I'm tough and I don't need help, to the digger and the Anzac spirit.
Okay, very timely, very timely.
And we've done some exceptional things over that. But the Anzac spirit says you'd do anything for your mate. That it didn't matter that you didn't know someone, but you would do anything for them. And if you saw that they were suffering a bit, you would ask and do everything you could because the collective was important. So what I'm suggesting is that what you need to be doing is saying it's your mates, and that should include your wife and your family and your partner and your friends, that I am helping them by going and get something checked out.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that's a very clever way, because at the moment, like, I think tradition has it that, you know, males do grow up with that, I must be strong, I must, you know, and let's be raw. You were talking about the blood in the feces as well. What are some of the other things that men tend not to like to talk about?
Well, chronic pain, ongoing headaches, drinking too much, feelings of total frustration and impotence. If you think that violence is a way to get rid of your frustration, then you need to talk to someone. As you know, as a psychologist, there is nothing wrong in 2014 with talking to a professional person about the things that you're feeling, and it can be wonderfully cathartic. Beyond Blue does an exceptional job. There's a website called www.mantherapy.org.au. We've seen the commercials with Dr. Brian Ironwood, who, by the way, is not actually a psychologist, but is a really good guy and very committed.
Absolutely.
And I love his fish in the background. Sure. But if you go onto the website and take some of their quizzes or their surveys, it will help point in places that you need to go about. And what I'm also suggesting, because it's so bad and so chronic, and if you're a farmer in the Southland of New Zealand watching this, or if you're a bank clerk in Cottesloe, we want you to be going in and checking things out, because we need to do it for your families and for everyone else.
And it's that mateship concept that I think people need to try and associate their health with.
Men need to say that we're in this together, not that it's just me. Not I'm not an island, I am a mate. I have, as the Anzacs did, I have everybody who's there with me is on the same team, and we're trying to work together.
Fantastic. And as we know, as you know, health practitioners, being proactive is much easier than waiting till you get down the course and then seeking help.
Well, the research,
although it's still important.
The research is so conclusive. If you get things early, I'm sorry, nobody likes to have a prostate exam, but then again, if you've got a partner, having a pap smear is equally as difficult and challenging.
Absolutely.
Go out there and get it done. It will be in your best interest. Dying young is not heroic. Dying young is letting people down.
Now, this is such an interesting conversation. Our time's going so quickly, so quickly. What's the next proposal that you had for the audience?
Yes, what I would like people to be able to do is to
That's okay. It is quite a full-on, very passionate topic, I think, and sometimes, you know, that releases us to have so much information to say. I think one of the things that we did talk about, as well as mateship, was also the way people will actually just generally think and approach their health.
Yes.
Yeah, so
We do need to change the way that we think about our health and look at the outcomes and the goals, rather than just looking at what's set in front of us. It's in everyone's best interest if we work together.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, look, thank you so much for coming on the couch. Always very informative.
And Neesha, you're a good mate too. and we'll look after each other.
We will. Thank you very much, Frank. That's very lovely. And our other great mate is obviously Fred and all the crew here on the couch. Everything. Oh, I'm all lovey-dovey now. But it's true. It's true. You need to watch out for your fellow colleague, friend, whoever it is in organisations too. You often see people, you know, for what, 48 hours a week or more now. So you do need to have that mateship. But look, of course, if you do need more information, as usual, you can go to thecouch.com.au. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you again very soon, Frank.
Thank you, Neesha.
And back to you, Fred.
I don't know where to go from there, Neesha, but our good mate over the other side also said to us, we're right out of time. So it's not good that we've got mates all around. But just quickly, Frank, I know you're into fishing. That's another passion. Yep. What's good at the moment to catch out in the water?
Well, I've just come back from redfin fishing in around Pemberton. It's absolutely sensational. Brim are moving down the river, and get out there and catch some squid and King George wading.
And did you see the guy who jumped on the carcass of the whale? What do you think of that?
That's the macho stuff we're trying to get rid of. That is plain stupidity.
Thank you. And on that note, I think well said to Frank Prokop. We'll look forward to having him back very, very soon. We'll take a quick break. Be back with more of The Couch right after this. Tayla Divitini talks movies. See you then. Well done, Frank.
This episode of The Couch is proudly supported by Cafe Bella Vista Restaurant and Pizzeria. Azito, give it a go with Azito. Refresh Pure Water. And Reading Cinemas, experience the difference.
You're right there, Fred, you're spilling it all over himself, look.
Sorry, Taylor. It's terrible, we should never eat when you're on television, so when I'm on television I won't eat. Taylor, welcome back.
Thanks for having me back.
You're filling in for Cameron Lynch doing movies.
I am. I'm the temp today.
The new girl.
I'm the new temp, yes.
What are we talking about today? We've got some great movies.
We've got three fantastic movies.
Want some?
I would love some. I've got one for you as well, Fred. And I've got brought some caramel popcorn from Coles. And this is also from Coles. We love Coles.
Wow,
don't
we just eat. We don't worry about the movies. We should just roll the trailers.
We should What's just roll the trailers. One? All right, let's do the first movie. Mm. The first one is called Interstellar. Mm. Now, Interstellar is set to be a blockbuster. We're here.
Yep.
Starring, you're right there.
Yeah, you're
flicking
okay.
It all over me. You're
good.
Fine. It's starring Matthew McConaughey, Anne Hathaway, and plenty of other popular actresses. Now, the movie is about the world is in crisis. Now, Matthew McConaughey is an engineer, but he's asked to go into space and find another planet which could be suitable for humans.
Mm.
Yes. Sound good to you? It sounds pretty good to me. Should we have a look at the trailer and then talk a little bit more about it? Here it is.
This world's a treasure. It's been telling us to leave for a while now.
Your daughter's generation will be the last to survive on Earth. You're the best pilot we ever had. Get out there and save the world.
Everybody ready to say goodbye to our solar system?
To our galaxy.
Here we go.
We want to get down fast, don't we?
Actually, we want to get there in one piece.
Hang on.
We have a mission. Our mission does not work if the people on Earth are dead by the time we pull it off.
We got this far, farther than any human in history.
Well, not far enough.
Make it count.
Where's the mountains?
Those aren't mountains. They're waves.
Am I going to make it?
Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
You might have to decide between seeing your children again. The future of the human race.
We'll find a way. We always have.
How good good does that look? Oh. Very interesting. Big difference from Magic Mike with Matthew McConaughey, hey? Mm. Better with his clothes on, I reckon. Mm. All right, let's go to the next movie. The next one is a comedy called Let's Be Cops. Now, this film...
Let's Be Pigs.
What? Yeah, Let's Be Pigs. Now, this film, not so great in the ratings so far, but I think it's a one to see, definitely. It's starring, let's see, the first actor, Jake Johnson, and Damon Wayans Jr., both from New Girl. If you've seen the New Girl on TV, they're from that show. I think it looks funny. Let's see what you think. Here's the trailer.
What happened, man?
How did we get so far off track?
What are you talking about? We both have good things going on right now.
Hey, didn't I see you in a commercial?
You did, yeah.
I have.
General herpes. What's up?
Hello?
You don't jump out on brothers, man. You don't like that.
So we're going to the party tonight. Cops or ghosts, your choice.
I don't want to be a ghost.
Let's be cops.
People actually think we're cops.
Please, freeze! Oh, that was awesome.
How far are we planning on taking this?
Where'd you get this thing?
eBay, dude.
This is super illegal, right?
This? No.
Huh?
Wow.
All units, domestic disturbance in progress.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No. Don't touch that. No.
Three females, early 20s, possibly intoxicated.
Oh, that's how it's sweet.
My bad.
I don't think they're ready for this one.
That is a fantastic movie.
It looks really funny. I don't see why people aren't really liking it.
12th of November, we've got a movie night at Reading Cinemas in Belmont. So if people would like to come, please contact us here at the couch and I'll give you some tickets if you live in Perth.
Sounds good to me. And last but not least, I've only got one more movie, and it is The Hunger Games, The Mockingjay Part 1.
Did you like The Hunger Games?
All right, to be honest, I've only seen the first Hunger Games, but, you know, it's for some people.
For me, that was
really
enough.
My type of movie, but it's full of action and...
full of crap, Nah, no, look, I know a lot of the crew.
I'll
tell you now, it's not a bad movie. I've watched one or two of them. Yes. I think there's only been two, hasn't there? Yeah. But yeah, good. Let's have a look at the trailer.
Very,
I suppose.
Very highly anticipated. So definitely
make your
to
own
see.
Mind up. Taylor's going to go and watch it.
Oh yeah, if you insist.
No one else can do this but her.
She won't be able to handle it. The games destroyed her.
Let her see what the Capitol did to District 12.
They're coming, Kenneth. They're going to kill everyone.
Prepare to pay the ultimate price.
I have a message for President Snow. If we burn, you burn with us.
I'm really hungry now.
Yeah, different type of hungry here in the studio.
Any excuse to eat.
Finally, it's over. We can hop into all the food now.
Let's have a look at the top five movies for this week. And they start at number five with...
We have Walk Among the Tombstones.
Number four, Tim Tammy.
Very funny movie. I've seen it. Very good.
Number three...
This Is Where I Leave You.
Number two...
Gone Girl.
And number one, Brad Pitt, if you love him.
Fury.
And it's going to be a really good movie. Thank you very much.
That sound very good.
What's your favourite movie at the moment?
Or let me see. I said the most funny one I've seen so far, definitely Tammy.
Okay, well
I really like that.
We saw Pride the other day. Do yourself a favour.
Pride, very good as well.
A lot of messages in it, but great funny movie.
Very good film.
So we loved it. Okay. If you missed anything on the show and you want to know how to contact us, there is a very simple way. Listen in. Adrian will tell you.
If you're looking for more info on anything you've seen on today's show, head to thecouch.com.au. It's where you'll find all the links for our guests. Plus clips from the show, backstage photos, and even exclusive movie reviews. You can also sign up as a Couchie and be part of our competitions, including Spin It to Win It. New Zealand viewers, that's open to you too. So jump online and check it out now. thecouch.com.au.
That is how you contact us here at The Couch, and we'd love to hear from you. Please join up as a Couchie, because you can be invited to some great movies that are coming up in November, or you can be on our Spin It to Win It competition, thanks to Azito. Now, I've had the pleasure of speaking to this great author. It's a great book called Bloom, Mental Health and Wellbeing. Her name is Tasha Broomhall, and she joins me in the studio. Hello.
Hello.
Welcome. Finally, we get to meet.
Thank you.
Now, Tasha, tell the people out there, on that camera there, tell us a little bit about you and your life.
So my background started off studying disability many years ago and then psychology, and I have been very fortunate to bring both of those disciplines together to work with people, helping them to understand the functional impacts of mental health issues in their lives.
Now, I said to this, the word mental health conjures different things for different people.
Yeah.
Can you give me a very quick description of what mental health can be?
Yeah, well, mental health is actually something that all of us have. It's just part of health. So mental health goes from where we're really strong, where we're buoyant, where we're able to deal with all the challenges of life, right down on a continuum to where we might have mental illness, where we're struggling, where maybe we have something like clinical depression or anxiety or schizophrenia or bipolar disorder. So mental health itself is the overall state that applies to all of us.
Is it basically anything that affects our mental state? So if I'm upset or stressed or depressed or lonely or unemployed or a marriage breakup, that could cause us a mental health issue.
It could cause mental health issue, but mental health issues are not necessarily mental illness.
Okay.
So we will all have times of feeling sad or feeling overwhelmed or grieving if we've had a relationship breakup or if we've lost our job. But that's just part of the fabric of the human experience. It's quite natural to have times of
sadness. So what are the signs we should be looking for if someone's got a mental health issue?
So if somebody's had some significant changes in the way that they engage with others, so the way that they feel about life, maybe they're not able to take pleasure or interest in the things they would usually be interested in. If somebody's very distressed and overwhelmed by emotions and doesn't see a way out of that, that's when we're starting to see that maybe it's a bit more than just a transient stage of stress and something maybe a bit more serious.
Now, my next question would be, how can you help people? And you're running some fantastic courses, aren't you?
Yeah, so we do a lot of workplace training. So we work with managers and supervisors, teaching them about mental health issues in their staff. We know that productivity is severely affected by mental health issues in workplaces. It's costing managers and companies a lot of money. So we teach them how to recognise the mental health issues and then how to respond appropriately.
It's sort of a vicious circle, isn't it? Because management wants lower budgets, they want to save money, but then they're causing stress and mental health issues, which costs them more money to manage in the way of compensation.
Absolutely. But there's really fabulous research that shows if we put the money into teaching the managers how to respond appropriately, and if we put some time into giving staff the skills, like in the book, about how to look after themselves, it'll save companies huge amounts of money down the track.
How can we get involved with your courses?
So go to our website, www.bloomingminds.com.au.
Are they very expensive?
No, there's a huge range, yeah.
And you help all different types of people, so people can give you a call after looking at the website?
Absolutely.
Now, just quickly, I know you've come in today to talk about this great book that I'm holding up here upside down. It's called Bloom. Tell me about the book.
So the book is designed to help people to recognise their own mental health needs and look after themselves. Mm-hmm. So some strategies to build your own buoyancy, as well as if you've got someone in your life who's experiencing mental health issues, some strategies for how to look after them and provide appropriate support.
Is it like
to them.
A quick guide as well?
It is very quick and simple. So the language is very non-clinical, non-technical language. So it's just an average person can pick it up and go, there's a few techniques I can apply right now today to myself. Or if I've got a loved one who's experiencing mental health issues, it'll give them great insight into what that person's experiencing.
It's a really important illness that people really misdiagnose, I think, or don't diagnose at all.
Yeah.
Can you give some advice out there what people need to do if they're sitting in front of the TV right now and saying, I'm all right, or maybe I've got a problem? What do they need to do?
They need to go and talk to somebody. So we recommend they start with their GP. If you go on the Beyond Blue website, you can see there's a map of Australia. You can put in your postcode, come up with a local GP that's great at responding to mental health issues, and anywhere around the world people can do the same thing. Just ring up their local practice and say, who's your GP there that's great with mental health issues? Go and see them, get a diagnosis, and then get some help.
And where can they get the book from?
From our website as well, so bloomingminds.com.au.
Fantastic. Can you tell me what the book's worth?
$22.
$22 is probably the best money you've ever spent, the best $22. Thank you very much for coming in today. You've shed some light on an amazingly growing illness around Australia, even with people who have reasonably good lives and don't even know it.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much. Good luck. We hope to see you again on the couch very, very soon.
Thank you, Fred.
That is, of course, Tasha Broomhall. She handled that very, very well. I need to take a quick break because we've got more of the couch coming up. And don't forget this fantastic book called Bloom. It's out there. Check out the website. See you soon. Well done.
This episode of The Couch is proudly supported by Cafe Bella Vista Restaurant and Pizzeria. Azito. Give it a go with Azito. Refresh Pure Water. And Reading Cinemas. Experience the difference.
You're very busy couch today, episode 503, here on Foxtel and Face TV New Zealand. Now, normally Ilse Strauss is in the house on this side, but today she's got her own guests talking business. Here's Ilse Strauss. Welcome back.
Thanks, Fred. Good to be here. And today I've got Alan Applegren and Kevin Abrahams from the Black and White Seniors Perth. Welcome along today.
Thank you for having us.
Excellent. So I wanted to ask you about the Black and White Seniors Perth initiative. So tell us a little bit about how it got started.
Well, about 14 years ago, a group of about eight people used to have regular meetings, and they decided that, or they chatted about some of the older people and how isolated they were and didn't have much contact with the general South African or expat South African community, and thought maybe they should do something about it. And they started an initiative where they could pick them up and take them for outings. But logistically, that got a little bit difficult because of getting into buses and finding out where all of them are. So they thought they'd raise some funds and put on a luncheon where they'd cook traditional food and entertain them traditionally. And from there, it's just grown and grown from strength to strength.
Fantastic. So this was 14 years ago, and it wasn't established by businesses or anything like that.
No,
it's
no,
a
no.
group of friends.
Just a group of friends who used to meet up regularly for drinks and chats and thought about the seniors in their community.
Wow. And so how did you two get involved?
Well, initially we were helpers. Alan's mother-in-law was one of the organizers, and they roped us in to help them set up initially. And from there we've taken over.
Yeah.
So that's how we got involved.
And so I just want to go back to the reason for starting this. What was it that they noticed about the elderly senior community who are, as you say, expats from South Africa?
Yep.
What was it they were noticing that caused them to really want to do this?
Well, some of them were in nursing homes.
Okay.
Some of them, their families had grown and moved on, and sort of as adults, you just get left by the wayside.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, these people thought about them and thought, well, you know, they really need to be part of us.
Yeah.
So maybe we should do something for them.
So it sounds like it was about starting to bring people
together.
Back together. Yeah.
Well, back in the day when there was only a handful of us.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
It was important that you try to meet as many of your people just to stop the homesickness.
Yeah. Yeah. And I can imagine that's a big issue for people who immigrate from a certain country to Australia, etc. So this is very important what your community has been doing. And so tell me, what are some of the highlights of this initiative that these seniors, the elderly and people really look forward to?
Well, the smiles on their faces, first of all.
Yeah.
They just can't stop thanking us for what we do for them.
Mm.
And
it's important, isn't
it? It's very important that we.
It's so important because when you look at it, they actually want to put their hands in their pockets to ask us to keep this thing going.
They love
to see us working around, and to them that have lost touch with some of their kids in instances, and then their kids are serving them, so it's like a whoa. What are you
full
doing?
Circle,
It sounds
and they
like
really enjoy it.
It's a lot bigger than what originally was intended.
Absolutely.
It means a lot to them. And so what happens on the day? So it's just happened about 2 weeks ago, is that correct? Okay, so this was which number was this one for the luncheon?
This was number 14.
Number 14. So 14
Well, we've been
years.
Doing it for 4 years.
Yeah.
But the our seniors that are now our guests, they started it and they've been running. And initially when we took over, we asked them to come along as ambassadors. So they... Because they were familiar with the older people, they would go around table to table and just thank everybody. And
Beautiful. So there's traditional cuisine, is there entertainment, things like that? What do they get to experience on the day?
Well, we do have some entertainment. We have a young man named Jerry and Mike who provide entertainment. We have a young lady named Jenny that plays the CDs, and they have been doing it from its inception as well.
Great.
So, yeah, they've been around from the beginning, and the people just love them.
That's excellent. And there's a lot of food, there's a lot of traditional things that occur on the day. I think we've had some photos already go up about and showing all the finer detail that happens on the tables, the beautiful glasses of champagne, is it, they get when they arrive?
Yeah, they're greeted with champagne and then they're allowed to have whatever they like. So if someone would like a scotch, they're allowed. If they want a Coke or a milk, they can have that.
Beautiful.
And it's just a chance for them to express themselves and meet their fellow friends that some of them haven't seen for 10, 15, 20 years.
Excellent. And what's important for viewers also to know is that this is a not-for-profit.
Absolutely. That's correct.
You guys make any money from this. This is done purely out of...
Love. Just to see their faces.
Yeah.
I don't care who you are, but on the day, to see the gratitude in their faces is just phenomenal.
And it's also about us giving back to our community, our parents and our grandparents who have sacrificed so much for us in the old country and here. Mm. So it's our way of saying thank you.
Beautiful. Yeah. Love it. And so tell me, what are the future plans for this? Where do you see this going? It's been going for 14 years now.
Yes.
And there's no, I can see there's no way of this ever being stopped. If people come along with that same type of motivation and hunger as what your committee does to be able to do this, because there's how many people involved in this now who help you
on the
make
day,
this happen?
There's about 30.
30 people.
And a waiting list.
That's incredible. So what's next?
Well, we have a succession plan in place, where we introduce our younger folk to what we do, like yourself.
Yours truly.
And they come along and they help in the kitchen, help on the floors. Mm-hmm. And the next stage is, we've been asked so many times, can we do this more often? And we just logistically can't.
Yeah.
So what we try to do is we'd hope eventually to have a place of our own where we can do this on a more regular basis. And
any
we'll
plans
see where it goes.
To expand at all?
Yes. We had someone come around from Melbourne. We had a lady come from Melbourne, and they would like to take it over to Melbourne and start a black and white seniors Melbourne, and hopefully we go from there.
So this is becoming a lot, not necessarily bigger than what it already is, but it's catching on.
People are seeing
the intention behind it and wanting to get involved for the right reasons.
That's right.
That's correct.
That's fantastic.
Sure.
So if anybody wants to stay in touch with Black and White Seniors Perth, you can jump onto thecouch.com.au. Alan and Kevin, thank you so much for coming in today. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us. It's a pleasure.
Absolute pleasure to have you here. You can jump onto thecouch.com.au. Thanks, Fred. Back to you.
Thank you very much, Ilse. And can I just say to Alan and, of course, your sidekick there, Kevin, which is Kevin, no wonder you don't get any money. You're serving scotch. and the other question I want to know is, not that I'm interested in the scotch, is there an age limit that so I want to attend myself?
Yes, there is.
Yes, there is. It's 65.
Oh, close enough. I'm 65. I've just turned 66. Do you check ID?
No.
Perfect. I'm feeling frail. Yeah.
Do you like a scotch?
Yes, I think two. Make it a double scotch and no ice. Well done, guys. It's so nice to see people in the community doing what we do as Europeans as well. We look after family and seniors as well. And I'm glad to see the rest of the community does the same. We value the seniors, very important people. And thank you to Ilse Strauss for taking a different role today. Great. Now, Spin It to Win It would normally be on today, but because Ilse took that segment, we didn't have time to do it. But if you want to be part of Spin It to Win It, this is how you get involved.
If you'd like to be a contestant on Spin It to Win It, all you have to do is head to thecouch.com.au, sign up as a couchie, and you'll be automatically registered to play. That website again, thecouch.com.au. Back to you, Fred.
Thank you very much. I need to go because I'm going to a very special black and white seniors night. Got my scotch ordered, and I don't like to let people down when it comes to scotch and food. So we need to leave you today. A lovely girl called Lauren Marsh is playing a fantastic song. She's centre stage. She's singing a song today, which is probably quite fitting. It's called Don't Rain on My Parade, because I'm going to have some great food and scotch, and I'll see you all next week. Good night, Australia. Good night, New Zealand.
And the sun's a ball of butter. Don't bring her out a cloud to rain on my parade. Don't tell me not to fly. I've simply really got to. If someone takes this spill, it's me and not you. Who told you you're allowed to rain on my parade? I'll march my band out. I'll beat my drum. And if I'm fanned out, your turn at bat, sir. At least you didn't fake it, hat, sir. I guess I didn't make it, but whether I'm the rose of sheer perfection, or freckle on the nose of life's complexion, or cinder or the shiny apple of its eye. I gotta fly once, I gotta try once, only could die once, right, sir? Oh, life is juicy, juicy, and you see I gotta have my bite, sir. Get ready for me, love, cause I'm a comer. I simply gotta march my outer drummer. Don't bring her out a cloud to rain on my parade. I'm gonna live and live now. Get what I want, I know how. One roll for the whole shebang. One throw, that bell will go clang. Eye on the target and wham. One shot, one gunshot. Get ready for me, love, cause I'm a comer. I simply gotta march my ass a drummer. Nobody, no, nobody is gonna rain on my
parade. Episode of The Couch is proudly supported by Cafe Bella Vista Restaurant and Pizzeria. Azito, give it a go with Azito. Refresh Pure Water. And Reading Cinemas, experience the difference.